Welcome to the Bentec 7X assembly cutting tutorial.
Before we start, we're going to go over some things that all of our customers should come to understand in order to use their software efficiently. The display area shows what we call a TriStar, which is used as a directional guide and starting point for most projects. The directions are defined as left, right, front, back, ceiling, and floor. Compared to the XYZ directional, this seems to be an easier concept for most people to understand. However, if you're used to having it another way, you can always change the look of the TriStar in the settings section if that makes you more comfortable. PickPoints are used for everything. So what are they? PickPoints are simply points in 3D space created by the user that are meant to define where the parts in the project will be placed. Once PickPoints are placed in the display area, you can build off of them by using them as reference points for other points. Most of the time, you can think of them as the end of your tape measure. Center line means exactly what it sounds like. Every line that you create in the assembly designer represents the very center of the material you're working with. Think about it like the way a wick runs through the center of a candle. The apex of the bend is really the intersection of two center lines, as if there wasn't a radius.
You can start by opening the Bentec software and selecting the assembly designer. From here, maximize the screen and select a material and die from their respective lists. In this tutorial, it doesn't matter what you choose since we're focusing on the cutting feature only, but you'll get the same values if you choose the 1-inch material and the 2-inch die. Now, select the Pick Points tab to begin creating our first part. Type 24 in the right field and click Apply to place the first point. Next, type 12 in the right field and click Apply. Then type 8 in the front field, leave the 12 where it is, and click Apply. Now type 12 in the front field and leave the 12 in the right field and click Apply again to finish. This is the outline of our part. Now we need to connect the pick points by placing our straight parts. So select the straight button and make 3 straight tubes by clicking each of the pick points in the display area as shown here. As you can expect, we'll need to cut both of the outer tubes so they can be welded to the center tube. So select the cutting tab and click the new cut button to start. Then select the left outer tube followed by the center tube and click complete. The cutting information will appear to the left under the cut list. Now repeat the same process on the other side. Select new cut, then the outer tube, followed by the center tube and click complete. Zooming in, we can see the cutting profile and what the tube will look like after the cut is performed. We can also click the Details button below in order to view the cutting wrapper and hole saw cutting information before it is printed out. Also, below the cutting list, users can print out the cutting wrappers, delete individual cuts, or flush them all from the list entirely. Now, let's see cutting details for a part including multiple intersections. With this intersection of tubes, you can see the two adjoining tubes will need to be cut, not only to the center tube, but to each other as well. So click the New Cut button and select the first tube which is going to be cut, followed by the one that isn't, and click Complete. Then, for the other tube, click the New Cut button, select it, and follow it up by clicking every other adjoining tube and clicking Complete. The cutting details should show a cut with a much more intense angle. Thank you for completing our assembly cutting tutorial. For more helpful and informational videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel and like us on Facebook.